When I wrote Udh Gaye, I recorded the entire vocal section. About 60 times I recorded it, but I ended up using the first vocal.
The first very evident memory that really hits me is, I think when I was around 6 or something, and I'd wake up to my mom's alap. And that's, I think, my very early introduction to music. I was in fifth standard when I started like composing music. And this is also around the time I was learning Indian classical music. I was learning Dhrupad. Because Indian classical has such a heavy, you know, strong initiation of like tradition, and you have to follow what's been there. I think creative freedom is very limited. Like that's what made me want to like, you know, start composing. Because I think this is around the time I really wanted to express a lot. And through Indian classical music, I really found my roots. And when I started composing music, I'd find like beats online and like, you know, record choruses and this and that. It was still limited because I was finding music online, you know, it wasn't completely mine. So the goal, I basically set a goal that I need to have complete creative freedom. From scratch to end, I need to have control over the track. And that's what made me want to produce music. So 2013 onwards, when I discovered like a Tiesto track online, and that's what really pulled me towards like electronic music at the time. Ever since then, I think things have been very focused on what my sound is, how I am being represented, you know, to the world. I dropped out of school when I was in 11th standard to pursue music. I was making an insane amount of music at the time. I think I was writing like a new track every single day because I was at a point in my life where I really wanted to, you know, prove myself. I would sit 16 hours a day and make music, but I'd never look at it as work, you know. I was having fun. And I can say that upfront, that you need to enjoy your work to a point where you don't have to look at it as hard work, right? I started earning pretty young. I was only 17, 18. I think it gave me a new perspective on how to, you know, save that money. And I think not just the years that I spent trying to really accumulate how to go about doing things. I think I go back to what I've always wanted to do, like goals that I'd set at a very young age, right? And for me to like, in order for me to like make them reality, I would need to, you know, save money and all of what I'm earning. So that really helped me process all of it. One of the main things right now that I'm really focusing on is a fashion line, a apparel brand that I really want to work on. While I also do this, I want to build a collaborative space, a studio, a very, very well conditioned studio, a place where, you know, other artists can come and explore and basically find out more about themselves, you know. You build an environment where you feel like making music or listen to music. That is the whole purpose. I don't want to build a studio where I have all the world-class equipment and all of that. That doesn't really matter. Financial planning is extremely, extremely important, especially for like a person like me who like to splurge a lot. But I think once you have a goal set in your mind, I think back of your head, you also know that, okay, cool, I need to stop at a certain point and I need to like plan this out, because if you really truly care about what you want to do in 5 years, in 10 years, you will save and you will make sure that that dream becomes a reality. And for that, I think financial planning is, I think, the first step to like just figuring out how you're going to make that reality, right? I think as an artist, as an entertainer, I think it's extremely important to take a break, right? And it's only possible when you have a backup, right? Which is like your savings and investments in place. So you're able to like not burn out and you are in a position to like stop work anytime you want. And that, I think, is only possible when that all of your earnings are in place and you're not like, you know, being reckless with your money.
Coming to this festival is also a reminder of where I was 3 years ago. My first memory will be the stage right here. 2017, I played a 6 p.m. slot here with 3,000 people. This place was packed. And I think it was very unreal for me to like experience that sort of crowd. And not just have that crowd, but also have everybody sing along. When I wrote Udh Gaye, I recorded the entire vocal section. About 60 times I recorded it, but I ended up using the first vocal. What I'm trying to say is that every everything that connects to you is like the first emotion, right? That first feeling, but hits you, you gotta grab it. So I think that's one message that I'd like to like let everybody know, that follow, pursue anything that you feel very strongly about and the first time it hits you.